Christina, and this is my second time attending Fontaine's mental health event, and it was absolutely amazing. I look forward to the third event. Bye-bye.
I pull up in these clothes, look so good, because I'm in that hole. You know, all these songs sound good, because I'm on that hole.
And her life and her work now is to empower young girls and young women who feel the same way so that she can help to pull them up. Because she's fought her way back, and that's the importance of Women's Mental Health Day. So please stand to your feet and help me welcome the woman of the hour, Ms. Fontaine Thompson. I do this because I have struggled with mental health issues at a very young age, as a teenager and as an adult. So this day means so much to me. I just want to make sure that women do not have to suffer and go through the things that I've been through. That's the reason I do this. Because I want to make sure that we have the information, we have the resources also to let everyone know that having mental health issues is a normal thing, but there are ways to deal with them.
I know people who say, I'm leaving therapy. Don't go. Do not go. Don't. But if you're curious and trying to figure out and explore some things because you're plateauing or you're hitting a wall and you need some more than what your friends are giving you, because it's like, I still feel like I need something else, I would suggest a therapist.
So learning how to deal with your trauma on top of being a functioning person in society, on top of taking care of family and friends, that's a lot to balance all at once. So I'm a strong advocate of being patient and gentle with yourself.
A lot of adolescents don't feel like their feelings are being validated when speaking to adults, and they don't have a safe space to effectively communicate these feelings because they're not feeling validated.